Assalamualaikum and hi! For today's topic, our group will be discussing about the application of linear algebra for a university student bicycle lifestyle. First of all, I will be talking about the introduction, while the objectives, methodology, results discussion, and conclusion will be presented by the rest of the group members. Introduction. Linear algebra is central to almost all areas of mathematics. How is linear algebra used in daily life? Linear algebra is massively used in field of science, mathematics, and engineering. Basically, linear algebra plays a vital role in determining unknown quantities. The equation of a line, also called linear equation, is represented with respect to the linear algebra.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Abdul Amin, and I'm about to explain the objective of this case study. First, the objective is to present the system of linear equation by creating an augmented matrix. The second objective is to apply the three rules, which are Serre's rule, Cramer's rule, and cofactor expansion. The third objective is to find the amount of f using the value of the determinants. And the last but not least, the objective is to use the system of linear equation to solve the problem. Next, the problem statement. Ali, Bakar, Daniel and Fitri is parked at three different places, which are student center, library and Islamic center. The total price for weekly bicycles parking rent for Ali, Bakar and Daniel is shown on the table. However, the total price for Fitri is unknown. Find the value of rent per day, which are X, Y, and Z, and total for Fitri weekly bicycles parking rent payment.
Now, moving on to the methodology, there is 4 steps in question 1 that we need to apply to identify the result. So first one is we applying the linear algebra. The second one, we applying the Serre's rules. The third one, we apply the Cramer's rules. And the last one, we identify the result. So, for the linear algebra, we got 313, 223, 412, approaching to x, y, and z, and equals to 9.4, 9.2, and 9.7. Serre's rule, we need to identify the S1 and S2. S1 is the purple line, S2 is the yellow line. So, we got the S1 equals to 30, S2 equals to 37. For the determinant of A, we need to minus S1 and S2. So, we got the determinant of A equals to negative 7. To find the value of X, Y, and Z, we can proceed with the Cramer's rules. Since we get the A determinant equals to negative 7, then we can proceed with this rule. For example, X equals to AX determinants divided by A determinants. Thus, we'll get X equals to 1.5. We also can apply these rules to Y and Z. Thus, we'll get Y equals to 1.3 and Z equals to 1.2.
For question number 2, we need to find the weekly total payment for Fitri's bicycle parking fee. To answer this question, we need to insert the value of X, Y, and Z that we received from the previous question. Then we will get the answer, which is RM9 for Fitri's bicycle parking fee weekly. Next, we will continue with the result for both questions. The result for the first question is X equal to RM1.50, Y equal to RM1.30, and Z equal to RM1.20. The second question is Fitri's bicycle parking fee weekly. The answer for this question is RM9.
In conclusion, based on our case study, we have learned and we found that matrices can be applied in real life in order to solve problems that related to linear system. To achieve that, we have tried to apply the matrices methods in our case study. For question 1, we have applied Serre's rule and Cramer's rule into the matrices that we have transferred the information in the tables into matrices form. From the calculation, we can get the actual rental prices of each place as for student center is RM1.50 per day, for library is RM1.30 per day, and Islamic Center is 1.20 ringgit per day. By doing that, not only we can find the rental prices, but we also can determine the average of places that they like to park their bicycle and total rental price in a week. Last but not least, from the calculation, we know that determinant can calculate the rental prices for each place that Fikri parked his bicycle. As a result, Fikri needs to pay RM 9 ringgit for 3 places that he parks in a week. Lastly, determinant's implementation can address the difficulty of linear equation on how we can apply those factors in real life.
Thank you so much for watching our video. Don't forget to like this video up, and if you have any question, kindly leave your question in the comment sections below. Bye!